Hey everyone, Dr. Ahmed Al-Hasni here from the Institute of Digital Dentistry. And I'm back again for another scanner unboxing video. This time the AS260 by the company Allied Star. Some of you may know about this company. As I reviewed their first ever intraoral scanner, which I have here with me, the AS100, back in January last year. Now, this was an interesting product because when I opened the box and I was greeted with this, you know, I probably wasn't expecting too much just because of its quite industrial design. But frankly, I was impressed by the performance, especially considering it was one of the first scanners which only needed a USB connection to work. And if you're interested, you can see my full review on this scanner, which will be in the caption below or on a button on the screen. So since January last year, which is almost 2 years ago, this company has been busy. In my review, I mentioned that the scanner really doesn't look so good and it kind of feels cheap. So what we found is that earlier this year, the company released their second generation scanner, the 200E, which I have here with me. And as you can see, looks much better than this first generation product. And it really built on the strengths of the AS100 while also improving a lot of the weaknesses. Now in the same year, the company has released its third generation scanner, which I have here, which is the AS260. So that means the company has released three scanners within 2 years. And that's quite incredible pace that these Chinese companies are moving. So before I unbox it and get into everything you get with this scanner, let's go over a bit of history. Allied Star is a relatively new digital dentistry company based in China. The company was established in June 2019. More interestingly though, just a few months ago in September 2023, it was acquired by Straumann Group and they announced that they'll be taking full control over the company. Yes, that Straumann Group, the one that sells the Virtuo Vivo. So there are certainly some interesting movements happening in the industry. And frankly, I'm super excited to see what a huge company like Straumann, with so many resources and incredible people working there, can do with an already quite amazing scanner product. But enough about that. We'll have to wait and see what the future holds. So let's open this up and find out what we get with the AS260. So as you guys can see, it's the characteristic hard shell case. This was the same with its wireless predecessor. And if I open the scanner right up, this is what we get. So first and foremost, this is the AS260 in all its glory. And what I like to see is that the company completely improved on the AS100 and frankly just used the same design as the AS200E. As you can see, these two scanners here look very similar. And I'm okay with this. I mean, this is a really good design. It looks very futuristic. And quite frankly, if I told most of you this is a product made from China, you probably wouldn't expect it. There are some differences between the wireless version and this wired version, which is the AS260. And notably, the wireless version has this little lightning bolt symbol and this one doesn't. And this all had to do with the wireless technology. It also had a connection indicator and this one doesn't. So what do we see with the AS260? It's got the same scanner button at the top and also at the back of the scanner. So these scanners have two scanner buttons. And I find this a really cool feature that Allied Star does. It basically means no matter how you're holding the scanner, you can access a scanner button. It also has this mode button, which is used to basically progress through the workflow. We've got this little plastic cap, which is characteristic of all these scanners that we get. And of course, if we pull this off, here you can see a connection for USB-C. And so this, once again, is a wired scanner. If I just put this aside here for a second, what else do we get in here? We get four scanner tips. And what I can see is that two of these scanner tips are adult size or kind of normal size. And the other two scanner tips are a smaller size. So the company gives you two smaller size scanner tips and two adult size scanner tips. Giving these small and large scanner tips is becoming quite a norm in a lot of intraoral scanners now, having the two different sizes. Typically, the smaller size are used for your pediatric patients. And with these scanner tips, they just simply click in and click off. Quite simple. Note, they are not reversible scanner tips. And one thing that's quite interesting, I asked the company about these scanner tips and they advised me that they can be autoclaved up to 60 times. The cost of the scanner tip is $20 per scanner tip. So that basically means it's about 33 cents per patient, because each patient you're going to be autoclaving them. I have been told, however, that the company is working on newer scanner tips that can be autoclaved up to 180 times. So that is quite interesting. If we go digging around, here we've got a book of manuals, and you guys know what I think of these. Not sure who reads them, but it goes over everything, a packing list, software guide, etc. I'll put that to the side. And in here we've got more goodies. Here we've got the cable, and it is sealed, which is a nice touch. So if I just pull this cable out, you can see that this is the AS260 cable. I have to say that the just general presentation and just general kind of packing of these products is quite a high standard now across the board. So this is the USB scanner, and what we also can see here is that the USB cable itself has these little protective covers. And if I take these out, you can see that this blue side obviously goes into the blue scanner end here, which is nice color coordination. And it seems to just click in nice and tight here, and in we go. So quite interestingly, there's no real screw or anything to keep this cable in, but it's definitely tied in there. So they've just made it this kind of channel, which as you put the cable in, you slot this plastic in here, and it keeps it nice and tight in there and almost reinforces the cable. Quite a cool design there. Once again, this is a single USB, and this is just it's not a USB-C, it's just a USB 2.0, which still impresses me that the scanner works so well. Well, not this one, but at least the predecessors worked so well, but I'm sure the company is really just using very similar tech to what seems to be an already great scanner. And yeah, simple USB connection right into the computer, and this is your wired version of the scanner, quite simply. Very similar in pretty much every element. The other thing is that this scanner seems quite light. I'm not entirely sure what exact weight the scanner is, but I'll put that on the screen for you. The other thing is that I am told by the company that these are drop resistant scanners. I'm not brave enough to just drop it at the IDD studio here, so we're not going to test it, but I'll take their word for it. And lastly, you don't find any calibration tools in here. So this is a completely calibration-free scanner. Another cool feature. And this is kind of the trend of all these scanners. They're all kind of turning to these lower cost scanners that are subscription-free and have no calibration tools. And so this is kind of a very interesting thing that we're seeing in the market. So what else do we get in here? What's left? Little desktop cradle. Again, super commonplace in the market. Nice design overall, and this is actually quite different to the one that came with the AS100. That was quite industrial as well. And also quite different to the one that comes with the AS200E. So this is quite futuristic looking, metal base, and interestingly, this charges the wireless battery, so I thought that was quite a cool design. This one, kind of stock standard, does the job. The scanner fits in. Let me see if I can do it. Just like that, fits a treat, and we'll put this on the desk. Lastly, this is a wall mount, and we've got the little tools here, again sealed up, and these are just little brackets and whatnot, quite common. Brackets to place this onto a wall if you would prefer to wall mount your AS260. And that's basically it that comes with the scanner. One thing to note that is not here is a USB. That's something that's very common with all scanners these days. And quite interestingly, if I just go over here, this is the manual and software download guide. And they just give you a QR code. So I think that's actually a pretty cool way of doing things rather than having to put USBs in every single scanner box. And that is everything that comes with the scanner. So a couple of things to note. First and foremost is that one of the biggest issues I had with these scanners, and you can read my reviews, was the software. I felt like, and I still feel this way, that we have reached some sort of hardware plateau. Intraoral scanners and the technology really is quite mature now. A lot of scanners work, but what's differentiating scanners is software. So the software that came with this was very basic, to the point where you don't even have patient management features. You can't really save patient files easily. The software with this improved, and the company is really taking software seriously, I hear, because they've released a whole new suite with this scanner, and that includes software applications. So a company that's super serious, even before the acquisition with Straumann. The software itself is completely free to use, and the company tells me that you get 10 gigabytes of free storage with the software. The last thing, and probably the most important thing, is price. So I'll give you a second to have a think and a guess. The cost of this scanner is actually 12,000 USD. So not quite the under 10K mark, but pretty damn impressive for a new scanner. Whereas this scanner now, the company has taken the opportunity to reduce down to 8,000 USD. And the wireless scanner, which is still the flagship, is 16,000 USD. And so this is basically the entire Allied Star lineup, the 260, the AS100, and the 200E. And quite interestingly, I would not be surprised if the company will be phasing this out. It kind of seems like that this one is the natural successor of this scanner. But it still is available, and it is only 8,000 USD, so it is a still capable scanner. It just looks quite a lot different to the successor now. And that's everything you get with the AS260. I will be busy reviewing this product, and I will share my review with you as soon as possible. If you have any questions at all, leave a comment below. Thanks for watching. And don't forget to stay up to date with everything digital dentistry. Check out our website at instituteofdigitaldentistry.com. Thanks for watching.